I got into teaching because I love working with kids. I love continuing learning. I feel like I'm a lifelong learner and I never stop. So just the process of discovering and continuing to grow appeals to me, and being able to pass that on to another group of people is really exciting. My favorite teacher is my 11th grade honors English teacher. She was unlike anybody I've ever had in my entire life, and she is the number one reason that I became a teacher, is that she changed the way that I approached learning. And when she brought that to me, I couldn't help but think that this is what I want to do. I didn't like following rules. I didn't like being told what to do. And from a young age was gifted, and so often bored in the classroom and not challenged in a way that I needed to be to keep myself engaged. And so when I try to engage my students, I think, what would Mrs. Edgar do? And so when I'm planning lessons, sometimes I give myself a pat on the back or like a silent cheer, because I'm like, she'd do this, that's awesome. We live in the desert and I have a group of about 40 kids that are learning how to surf. And it's an after school club activity that is just blowing up. People looked at me like I'm the crazy lady. Actually, one of my friends who is working on the Palm Springs Surf Club, he every time you see him, he's like, there's that crazy lady from the desert, because it was this just vision, this passion that I had. I started surfing and I was like, how can I keep this to myself? I can't. Like, I have to share the feeling of freedom, the peace, the healing that comes from being in the ocean, and I need to bring it to these kids. Everything about my teaching is I want them to see it as something relevant, something that they can use. Incorporating social justice into my lessons is essential. It's not even an option for me, because I teach in a marginalized community. I have students who don't feel like they can rock the boat. And so giving them those tools to advocate for themselves, to find their voices, and to feel like what they have to say matters and deserves to be heard, is one of the most important things that I can do in my classroom.
They felt that it was too harsh.
Yeah, you're right, Leslie, absolutely. So the prosecuting attorney felt, even though they did their job, they got the conviction. Students are more than just students in the classroom. Seeing the people that come to us as whole humans, and knowing that they have unique struggles, that they have things going on in their lives that we don't see on the surface. And so I try and create an environment that's very inviting, that lets them know that they belong. Oh my gosh, I love that you're sharing screens. Look at this teamwork. Sorry, I got too excited. I want every kid that comes into my classroom to leave knowing that they matter and that they have the power to do things that they might not have thought was possible before they came to me.